Good day. My name is Gilmark Miguel Ramirez, a second-year student of Chemical Engineering Department from Technological Institute of the Philippines, under CHE 22S2. My motto in life is, sometimes you win, sometimes you learn. In order to answer the CHE-related courses or problems in the areas of Physical Chemistry 1, Physical Chemistry 2, Analytical Chemistry, and CHE Calculations, I developed a tool called CHE Problem Solver using MATLAB. Now, for the first section of the code, this is the one that welcomes the user when they utilize the CHE problem, CHE issue solver of the four CHE courses or their choose from. It will immediately pose four questions after choosing one. So let's begin with the first course, which is the Physical Chemistry 1. So if you choose the Physical Chemistry 1, this would be, and here is the how the MATLAB program renders it. All four of those Physical Chemistry 1 questions are resolved by this section of the code. It uses mathematics and request input for the user in order to solve the problems in the questions. So here's the question number 1 for the Physical Chemistry 1. Calculate the pressure exerted by 1.56 grams of CO2 compiled in a flask of volume 320 cubic decimeter at the temperature of 320.15 Kelvin. So if you we need to enter the mass of the substance, which is the 1.6 grams. Enter the R values, which is 8.314. Enter the temperature, which is 320.15. Enter the molar mass of the substance, which is the CO2, and its molar mass is 44. And lastly, enter the volume, which is the 320. So if you input all of them, then it will result to the pressure, which is 0.29. For the question number 2, what is the pressure given 3.74 moles of substance in a 1.9 liter flask at 310.15 Kelvin? So we need to enter the moles of the substance, which is 3.74. Enter the R values, which is 0.08205. And enter the temperature, and the temperature is said as 310.15. And enter the volume, and the given volume of this problem is 1.9. So the pressure of this problem is 50.09. Question number 3. What would be the temperature if a 6.37 substance is kept in a 4.2 liter tube at 1.67 atmospheric pressure? So we need to enter the moles of the substance, which is the 6.37. And the second step is we need to enter the R values. So we need to type 0.08205. We also need the pressure, and it indicates that the pressure is 1.67. And lastly, just enter the said volume, which is the 4.2. After that, it will come up with the result that the temperature is 13.42. Next, the last question for the Physical Chemistry 1. Find the volume the substance contains 3.62 moles compressed in 1.5 atm at 323.15 Kelvin. So, we need to enter the moles of the substance, which is the 3.62 moles. Enter the R values. The R values of this problem is 0.08205. Enter the temperature. So we need to input the temperature of the problem, which is 323.15. And lastly, enter the pressure. The pressure on this problem is said to be that 1.5 atm, so we need to enter 1.5. As a result of that, the code will determine the volume, which is the 63.99. So let's proceed to the next subject, which is the physical chemistry 2. This section of the code is supposed to provide solutions to all of the physical chemistry 2 issues. It includes R values, CV, initial and final temperatures, as well as the formulas to solve for the molar entropy and Gibbs energy. So if we enter the number 2 at the said problem, the physical chemistry 2 subject will provide the 4 questions that we need to answer. This is what it looks like. So let's proceed to the question number 1 of the physical chemistry 2. What is the molar entropy of a system going through isobaric heating from 300 Kelvin to 368 Kelvin? Assume the gas is diatomic. So we need to enter the specific heat at constant pressure when gas is diatomic. So the specific heat of the gas when it is diatomic is 7 over 2. We also need to input the initial temperature in Kelvin, which is 300 Kelvin, and enter the final temperature, which is 368. As a result of that, the molar entropy in joules over mole Kelvin is 5.94. For the question number 2, in a system, a polyatomic gas is heated through an isometric process from 298 Kelvin to 420 Kelvin. Calculate the molar entropy. So first, we need to enter the specific heat at constant volume when gas is polyatomic, which is 3. Then, we need to enter the initial temperature in Kelvin. So we need to enter 298. Enter the final temperature in Kelvin. So we need to input the 420. As a result of that, the molar entropy in joules over mole Kelvin is 9.99. For the question number 3 of the physical chemistry 2, the change in volume accompanying fusion of solid CO2 is negative 0.000343 cubic meter over mole. Determine the change in molar Gibbs energy of fusion when the pressure is increased from 10,524 pascals to 56,213 pascals. The code says that we need to enter the change in volume in cubic meter over mole. So the change in volume in cubic meter over mole is negative 0.000346. Next is we need to enter the initial pressure in pascals, which is 10,524. Next, enter the final pressure in pascals. So we need to input 56,213. As a result of that, the molar Gibbs energy in joules over mole is negative 15.81. For the last question in physical chemistry 2, calculate the change in the molar Gibbs energy of a perfect gas when its pressure is increased isothermally from 69 atm to 192 atm at 325.15 Kelvin. The first is we need to enter the initial pressure in atm, which is 69. The second, we need to enter the final pressure in atm, which is 192. Enter the change in volume in Kelvin. It said in the problem that the change in volume in Kelvin is 325.15. So, as a result of that, the molar Gibbs energy in joules over mole is 2,766.52. So let's proceed to the third subject, which is the analytical chemistry. This section of the coding is in charge of solving analytical chemistry problems. It asks the user to enter the required volume as well as concentration and molarity formula in order to solve the problems. Here it is what look like when you enter the number 3, which is the analytical chem. It shows the four questions that we need to answer. And let's begin with answering the question number 1. Determine the molarity of 0.82 mole of COCl2 in 5.7 liter of solution. So we need to enter the moles of solute, which is 0.82. Then we need to enter volume of solution, which is the 5.7. As a result of that, the molarity of the solution is 0.14. Next question. You have 9.84 liters of a solution that contains 5.2 mole of sodium chloride. Find the molarity of the solution. Then, the first requirement is we need to enter the moles of the solute, which is the 5.2. And enter the volume of the solution in liters. The volume of the solution in liters in this problem is said to be that 9.84, so we need to enter 9.84. As a result of that, the molarity of the mixture is 0.53. Next question. If 275 grams of chlorine is dissolved in water so that the volume of the solution is 824 ml, what would be its concentration? With the given, the mole of Cl is 35.453 grams over mole. Enter the mass of solute, which is 275. Enter the molar mass of solute, which is the molar mass of the chlorine, which is said to be 35.453. Enter the volume of solution in liters. The volume of solution in liters in this problem is 824. So the concentration is 0.01. So let's proceed to the last question in analytical chemistry. What is the mass of solute in a 7.69 liter solution of 0.567 molar mass of glucose? The molar mass is 180.156. So the first requirement is we need to enter the molarity of solution. So that is 0.567. Enter the molar mass of solute. So we need to input the 180.156. Enter the volume of solution in liters. The volume of solution in liters in this problem is said to be 7.69. So we need to enter 7.69. So, if we input those three correctly, it will come up with the answer of the mass is 785.52. So, this section is the responsibility of this section of the code is to resolve the problems resulting from chemical engineering calculations. It includes the moles that are required to solve a particular problem that is given, as well as the initial and final temperatures, volumes, both the initial and final points, and also its pressure. So it is what it looks like. It looks like when you enter number 4, if you run the code, it displays the questions in CHE calculations from 1 to 4. So let's begin with the number 1. 12 moles of a certain gas with conditions measured at 5.6 atm of pressure and 3.6 of volume was put in a piston cylinder. When the setup was heated with no changes to its pressure, the volume was determined to be 9 liters. So calculate the final temperature of the gas. We need to enter the amount of moles, which is the 12. Next is enter the amount of pressure in ATM, which is the 5.6. Enter the initial volume, which is the 3.6. Enter the final volume, which is 9. So as a result of that, it will come up with the final temperature of the gas is 551.60 Kelvin. So question number 2. When the constant pressure heat capacity is 43.56 joules over mole times Kelvin, what is the constant volume heat capacity? So it is only required to enter the constant pressure heat capacity to answer the constant volume heat capacity, which is the 43.56. And if we input that, it will come up with the result of 35.25. Next question. Calculate the work done by a sample of 0.95 mole argon gas that it expands isothermally from 1.88 liters to 3.78 liters at 278 Kelvin. According to the following condition against a constant external pressure of 1.8 atm. So the first is we need to enter the external pressure against the system in atm, which is said to be that 1.8. Next is enter the initial volume of argon gas in liters, which is 1.88. Enter the final volume of argon gas in liters, which is 3.78. As a result of that, the work done by the sample argon gas in joules is -346.53. And the last question for the chemical engineering calculations, when the constant pressure heat capacity is 86.73 joules over mole times K, what is the constant volume heat capacity? Enter the constant pressure heat capacity, which is the 86.73, and it will come up with the result of the constant volume heat capacity is 78.42. Finally, this part of the code is the one that is responsible for looping the program. If you notice, whenever we solve one problem, a program will ask us if do you want to continue or not. If we type yes, it will automatically redirect you to select CHE courses as shown in this left side part of the presentation. And if you selected no, it will greet you as said, thank you for using CHE Problem Solver. And that's it for the presentation of my code. Thank you.